just real quick, it's 5:45 in the morning on Sunday morning. Week was brutal, mentally and emotionally. I mean, the PTSD episode and stuff that I posted about on social media. I just wouldn't wish that on anybody. I don't, having to go through it and stuff is just, I mean, I don't even really want to rehash it or even talk about it. I talked about it enough on social media. The other thing is that after all that, me and Diz had to jet. We had to get away. So a day trip to Helen, Georgia. I drank too many Warsteiners and then a fifth of Green Label Evan Williams. And needless to say, my state was altered and everything went away for a little while. And that's the truth. You know, I'm not saying that's the way that everybody should deal with a week like I had, but that's the way I dealt with this week. Or that's the way that we dealt with this week. And so that's the other thing. The we. I'm stoned and tired. Yes, I found someone, or maybe it's better put that someone found me. And she believes in me. She understands me the best that she can. The things she don't understand, she's not afraid to dig into, to sink her teeth into. So, she loves me, and I love her. I do. Very much, Diz. And, I wouldn't have thought that I would have even uttered those words more than likely ever again, four or five months ago. I've known her for a little while, and I probably pushed her away longer than I should have. I might have embraced my emptiness too long. But she stuck with me and was pretty persistent in what we could accomplish together and what she saw a little bit further down the road. And I'm so very thankful. And she's helped me so much that I can't imagine my life without her at this point. And it's weird because I love Lisa. I will always love my limited edition. You know, there'll never be another, and she will never be replaced. And I know that I'll always get shit about what happened, and I'll always give myself shit about what happened. And I'm not gonna wither up and dry out and die inside. I don't think.
And
I don't think that Lisa would want me to. So, yeah, I'm not going to let Diz pass me by. I'm not. I will try to make her the happiest woman that I possibly can. And that's all I know to do to self-preserve myself and something that I believe in. And that's, as cheesy as it may be, I mean, that's love. I believe in love. I'm another boring, hopeless romantic. And I'm full of flaws and I deserve it. I mean, I've worked too hard and too long on myself, and the people who have stayed, the people who are brave enough to even stay remotely close to me, my goodness, I mean, the shit you've had to listen to and see and put up with is, I can't even begin to define how much so many of you have helped. I know there's a long way to go, and more than likely there is a short time to get there. Everything takes its toll on everyone. There's not a person watching this video that doesn't have something that breaks you down so far that, you know, you do want to tap out in one way or another, you know. But then there's those things like, seeing her eyes and her smile, and to be genuinely happy to reach out and grab my hand walking through the North Georgia mountains is, it's very strengthening. So, if there's some of you that don't like it, I won't say that I'm sorry for it, but, you know, suck it up, buttercup, because it's not my fault. It's not my fault that you can't get through your head that love is worth fighting for and working for. And I mean real love, not your romantic comedy movie or sitcom. I mean unconditional fucking fist in the wind love. I've been lucky enough to have found it more than once. And every time, they're all uncomparable.
Hello, my friends. This is Brett Michaels of Poison.
And
this is called I Want.
They were all worth it.
I want action.
And you can bet your ass that I'll make sure that Diz is no different. She's worth it. She's worth it all. Oh my goodness.
Uh-oh. I told you.
Thing number 251.